A lot of people have videos on the BRRRR strategy, the BRRRR method. I see them all over YouTube. But what I always miss is it happening in the real world. I see a lot of people talking about strategy, theory, thought. But when nuts come to bolts, where is the real world experience? Where is the deal for you? That's what we're doing in today's show. Chris from Virginia, this is your video. Let's dive in. This is your show. This is the show where I work for you directly, taking your needs. I'm going through the MLS and I'm trying to find the best possible deal for you guys. Put down 25%. That's the perfect way to buy this. That's why real estate investing is the greatest industry in the world. Hey, folks, welcome to another episode of the MLS Search and Analysis Show here on Holton-Wise TV. As always, I'm your host, James Wise, doing something a little different today. I am coming to you guys from the home office, right? Just had another baby, so myself, I'm staying home with the family, helping out. We got a couple kiddos running around in diapers, so it's a lot to handle, right? So we need more reinforcements, right? You got to have a better kid-to-parent ratio when they're all running around. And the cool thing about my life is I can do that, right? I can essentially take an undisclosed or unlimited amount of time at the home because I'm still able to manage my business, operate my business, do my business from home, right? With real estate investing, it's one of those great investment vehicles, one of those great ways to make money that you can literally do it from wherever you are, right? That's honestly why a lot of you guys come to us. I mean, honestly, it's probably why most of you guys come to us, right? You're looking for the financial freedom, right? And, you know, you see people talking on the internet, just like, you know, I say they're talking about BRRRs everywhere. You see BRRRR deals everywhere, all over YouTube. Man, everybody's got a BRRRR video, right? But everybody's also got like a financial freedom video. Like, yo, invest in real estate, you get financial freedom, blah, 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 blah. Like, what I think though, like, that kind of irks me a little bit is I feel like everybody's pitching this idea of financial freedom, like you buy some real estate and then you never have to work again. That's ridiculous. That's not what financial freedom means, at least not what it means to me. What financial freedom means to me is you have the ability to continue to work, but you can work on your own terms, right? Like me, I just had another child and I'm choosing to work from home versus my studio, right? It's up to me. I can still manage my business, run my business, operate my business, help investors like you, but I could do so here at home. I could spend an hour, you know, on Zoom here filming this video for you, Chris, and then I can go change diapers, feed babies, and then I can come back and do some more work, right? It's not like I got to drive an hour and a half, 2 hours in traffic to work. I'm stuck there for 10 to 12 hours, then I can come home at the end of the day. I miss my family, right? I could you know, design my life and my work to be seamlessly integrated. And I would have never been able to do that had I not got into real estate investing. And it is my goal to help you accomplish that goal, brother. And you are from Virginia, right? So that's what it's all about, man, financial freedom, right? You don't physically need to drive to Cleveland, physically fly to Cleveland, physically come to Cleveland to paint a house or to, you know, got a kitchen or things like that, right? You're able to work on your own terms. You could operate this business. You could work on this business from the comfort of your own home. And what you're trying to do, right? You're trying to get this business started. You have $75,000 to invest and you'd love to utilize the BRRRR strategy. So I found a particular property that I think will do just that. I think it will foot the bill. I think you'll enjoy it. 7805 Elton Avenue, Cleveland, 44102. This house was listed about a week ago, okay? Listed by a real estate agent out of a Century 21 office for $51,000, right? Now, this particular house, in my opinion, is not gonna sell for this $51,000, dude. I think the agent is really letting their client down, which is really good for us, which is really gonna allow us to perfect the BRRRR strategy, right? Just topic of clarification. I presume everybody knows what the BRRRR strategy is. I mean, I've done freaking 50 videos on this thing. And again, I said top of the show, everybody's got a BRRRR video. But just to clarify, BRRRR stands for buy, renovate, rent, refinance, repeat. We're going to take a guy like you, Chris, we're going to take your $75,000 and stretch that out as far as we possibly can, right? And I think this BRRRR, this deal is going to work for a BRRRR because I think the listing is stinky. I don't think they did a good job marketing it, right? First of all, look at this picture. That's it. That's all we got. We got one picture. We have no information other than this one crummy picture. Clearly, the home isn't being upkept very well. It looks to me like we got blankets in the windows. There's stuff all screwed up on the roof. The yard is just totally unkempt. Like there's a different sheet in the upstairs window. Like you could tell a lot from this picture, right? Basically, like a lot of stuff is not being attended to in this particular house, right? It does currently have a tenant. That tenant is paying $850 a month. That's also going to help me and you, right? These are all things that are good for me and you, bad for this particular seller, right? We have a tenant who's paying too little rent. You know, maybe the seller doesn't understand how much rent they could be getting, or maybe they just, you know, never put in the effort to actually fix the home up and make it nice to get a market rate tenant. So they rented it below market rate, $850. In reality, this should rent for $1,000 a month to a Section 8 tenant or $12,000 a year. Now that $1,000 is actually kind of conservative. Honestly, my team, we're probably going to try to advertise this for like $1,065, $1,085, somewhere in there. Because when we go on the voucher programs, which by the way, this property has to be a Section 8 property, dude. It would be crazy not to. This is a D-class neighborhood, but it's close to Metro Health. I'm sure you've heard me talk about Metro Health before. If you haven't, huge healthcare hub. They're investing $1 billion into the Cleveland market, okay? This property is very close to that, right? It's also directly bordering some really nice areas, Ohio City, Tremont, Gordon Square, Edgewater, stuff like that, right? So I believe this neighborhood is eventually going to be way up, go way up on the upswing. So I think we have the opportunity to get into a potentially gentrifying neighborhood very, very cheap right now. But the risks are still going to be there, right? The high risk stuff, high risk neighborhoods. So what we do is we essentially utilize Section 8 as a cheat code, right? We get into this high risk neighborhood, but we make sure the one thing, the biggest problem with high risk neighborhoods is you can't collect the rent every month, right? Well, we eliminate that issue by getting the government guaranteed rent. So with all that said, it's a long-winded way of saying when we go on these Section 8 programs, a lot of times they give us a little bit more rent because we got a second bathroom. So I did it at 1,000, which is what a lot of our three beds get over there, but possible we could actually overachieve. I don't know if overachieve is a word. I'm running on very low sleep. I may have mentioned this earlier on the show, but we just had another kid. So, you know, not a lot of sleep happening right now, so sometimes I won't make up some words, but stick with me, brother, okay? So 1,000 is conservative, but possibly a little bit higher, right? Of that 1,000 coming in, I anticipate an average of 464 going out, leaving us with an NOI of 536 a month, an average of 6,432 a year, okay? Now, as far as pricing goes, I beat up the listing agent. I said I thought the listing agent did a crummy job. No information. The seller's renting it for too low. The property's in disrepair. I think because of that and the fact that you're a cash buyer, dude, I think we can come in aggressive and try to wrangle this thing for $35,000. If that's the case, if we could take it up for $35,000, we absolutely should. And we should continue to collect that $850 a month until that tenant naturally turns over. When that happens, brother, that's when we make our move, right? That's when we make the move to renovate this. You don't want to create artificial turnover. If that money's coming in, let's let it come in, right? Because I gave you your average expenses, right? $464 a month. Well, $850 is the rent, right? So there's still cash flow. So collect that cash flow, okay? Collect the cash flow till the cash flow stops, till the taps, keep drinking the water till the tap stops. When the tap runs out, that's when we do our renovation. And I'm assuming we're going to have probably a $30,000 renovation. Now, I don't have very much information on this property, but did I pull that number out of my ass? No, I'm going to tell you how I got that number. Renovated freaking so many homes, dude, so many homes. Cosmetically, no matter what this thing looks like, I pretty much almost all the time, we can cosmetically put this thing back together for about $20,000. That's going to be going through, patching all the holes in the walls, making sure we refinish the hardwood floors that are there, pulling out any carpet, hardening it, installing Home Depot Lowe's quality fixtures in the kitchen and the bath, right? We could typically do that for approximately $20,000, maybe a little bit above $20,000. The rest, I've left that open because I know we're going to have to do some of the big ticket items. Roof, about 5,000. Furnace, 3,000. Hot water tank, about 1,000. Do I think we need to do all three? Maybe not. But we shouldn't go into this assuming we're not going to have to do any of those three. So I think right now, $30,000 is a very reasonable expectation for what we can do, what we need to budget to get this thing totally put together, right? Now, of course, we're going to make our offers contingent on a third-party home inspection, right? And then when that home inspector goes in there, there could be things that, you know, blow the deal, right? If it turns out there's a major structural issue, well, that's going to cause concern. We may have to either kill the deal or back out of the deal, or kill or back out of the deal, or we may have to try to renegotiate the deal. But other stuff, knick-knack stuff, like broken window here, leaky pipe here, you know, furnace being old, things of that nature, none of that is going to blow that $30,000 budget. I mean, dude, just looking at the outside of this property, you should not assume everything looks great. It doesn't, right? Like, there's no way, right? We're definitely going to be doing a renovation of that scope, okay? So we're going to get a little more information at the home inspection, but that's a pretty fair estimate, dude. I've literally rehabbed hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of these things. So, like, you know, I kind of know what we're doing, right? We have like a whole renovation plan. We make a lot of these homes look exactly the same, right? That's what you come to us for, right? We systemize the process, okay? So if we pick it up for 35, we drop 30 into it, you're all in at 65. At that point, I'm anticipating we'll get it to appraise at 75. That means the bank will give you back $56,250, thus only leaving $8,750 into the deal, which is a 41% return on your money. You're starting with $75,000, brother. When we are done, you're going to have a cash cow, fully renovated cash cow, and you're going to have, what is that going to be like, $67,000 left for us to do the second deal and the third deal and so on and so forth, right? So that, my friend, is how we utilize the BRRRR strategy to build you a large real estate portfolio. This is a real life BRRRR deal, right? This is us showing you an actual property. We are an actual property manager, actual real estate broker, actual general contractor that will actually go in and physically do this work for you, right? So I'm not just out here giving you guys like this rah-rah, yo, y'all want to work from home like me? Do this, this, and this. Good luck, motherfuckers. Like, we're not doing that, right? This is a real property. Chris will actually be able to wire in money, send it to Holton-Wise. He will own this property. We will renovate the property for them. Guys that work in my office will physically be ripping toilets out of this home, right? Things of that nature, right? This is actual real business. Chris will operate remotely from wherever he wants to. Right now he's in Virginia, but the dude can move to China or Hawaii for all we care. He'll still be able to run this thing from anywhere in the world, guys. That's what we do differently here on Holton-Wise TV, right? We give you guys the education like everybody else, but what I think we do better is I think we're more transparent about our education. I think we give you the good and the bad, and we couple that with actual deals, an actual team on the ground, so you could actually, you know, just take action on what we're teaching. Everybody else is just like, yo, buy my course and then good luck, right? Well, you know, here we back up what we're saying with real life deals. If you ever drive through Cleveland, just drive around Cleveland, bro, you will see the Holton-Wise name on trucks, on hundreds of houses. You will see our signs, our name everywhere. Talk to people in the Cleveland market. There is nobody with a bigger real estate presence or real estate portfolio than Holton-Wise. So we put our money where our mouth is. We not only talk the talk, though, we do walk the walk. So Chris, if that all makes sense to you, reply to the private email, and then we'll get that offer written up contingent on that third-party home inspection. We'll go from there. Everybody else, if all this sounds pretty cool, you're interested in working with our team and the way Chris is, it starts with this show, the MLS Search Analysis Show. So what you want to do is you want to go to HoltonWise.com, click the Property Search for Sale tab, click the MLS Search Analysis Show, order yourself a package of properties, and then we'll send you an email after you make your order, gathering as much information about you as we can, your wants, your needs, your goals. And then together, you and I will put together a customized real estate investment plan of attack for you. And then my team will enact upon that. That's all I've got for today, folks. Thank you for sticking around. As always, I'm James Wise with Holton-Wise, and this is Real Estate Investing Made Easy.
This is your show. This is the show where I work for you directly, taking your needs, I'm going through the MLS and I'm trying to find the best possible deal for you guys. Put down 25%. That's the perfect way to buy this. That's why real estate investing is the greatest industry in the world.
US REIB is a full-service, turnkey provider offering investors the opportunity to purchase single-family and multifamily investment properties in Cincinnati, Ohio, Dayton, Ohio, and Kansas City, Missouri. The purchase process is seamless, from reserving a property to obtaining financing, inspections, and insurance referrals. US REIB has a dedicated team in place to manage the process from start to finish. In addition, US REIB is also directly integrated with its own private placement fund for accredited investors. The fund seeks to raise $10 million to capitalize on the repositioning of distressed single-family and multifamily real estate.
RentTech Direct provides you with an easy-to-use yet robust platform for managing your properties, complete with its built-in reporting and accounting system that can be customized to fit your business. For property managers, you get advanced features like simplified owner distributions, automated management and placement fees, an owner portal, plus the software is certified for trust accounting. All this comes backed by the highest rated customer support team in the industry, certified by third parties and ranked number one by our clients year over year. You get unlimited free access to our US-based support team by phone, email, and chat, who will help you getting started or anywhere along the way.
G'day everyone, it's Angelo Remora here, your favorite Australian and the founder and owner of Ohio Cashflow. Over the last 5 years, Ohio Cashflow has established itself as the most reputable turnkey real estate investment company in the country. We offer solid B-class properties in Toledo, Ohio. We work and live in the same areas that we sell in. So when we sell your property, your tenants become our neighbors. We only take on a handful of investors every month. So for your chance to work with one of the best in the business, please fill out our investor application form, which you can find in the video notes below. Thanks for listening. And as we say down under, I'll catch you later, mate. Is that it?
Yeah, we're done.
All right, cool.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on our latest content, including video tours and analysis of investment properties that are available for sale, real estate investment education, and our most interesting encounters with tenants from hell. Holton-Wise, real estate investing made easy.